Hello everyone, Burger Brush here once again, and today I want to go over how to prepare for doing maps after finishing Act 10 Kitava. So after you finish Act 10 Kitava, he will start off by lowering your elemental resistances by minus 30%. Kitava also does this after you defeat him in Act 5 as well. But the main thing to focus on is after you finish Act 10 Kitava, you really need to fix your elemental resistances. Other things that we're also going to focus on is life pool, different form of defenses, and if you have enough damage to actually start mapping as well. First of all, I want to say, after you finish Act 10 Kitava, you will then be transferred to Orioth, and the first thing that you can actually do is go up to the left over here, where Helena is standing. She will give you a crafting recipe that will give you the highest rank of movement speed craft, that you can craft movement speed on your own boots from now on. Also, what you want to do is that you want to talk to Lani and receive your skill points, and after you've done that, you want to do slash passives, and you want to have a look at if there's any passive skills that you missed from different quests. You can scroll up and you can look through all the different quests that give skill points, and the main thing that you can do is that you can look at this number here, 24. If it says 24, then that means that you have all the skill points in the game and that you choose to kill all the bandits in the Act 2 bandit quest. If it says 22 and you see that it is a zero next to deal with the bandits, it means that you choose to save one of the bandits and receive the buffs that they give. Now, one of the main things that you have to focus on as soon as you finish Act 10 Kitava, if you want to start mapping, is that you have to take a look at your elemental resistances. So when you have elemental resistances on your character, you kind of lower the damage taken from different forms of elemental sources. Like, let's say you have no elemental resistances at all against, for example, lightning damage. And if you take lightning damage at that point, you're going to take an increasingly high amount. But if you have elemental defenses against, like, lightning damage, then you're not going to take as much. So what you need to do is that you need to click C to open up your character sheet. And then what you do is that you go and check your defense charter here. And you scroll down and you look at the resistances here. Fire, cold, lightning, and chaos. Basically, in Path of Exile, the highest form of elemental resistances that you can have is 75. Anything above 75 will actually not give your character that amount of resistances, because 75 is the max. But there are certain things that you can do in the game to increase your elemental resistances, such as Survivalist giving you +1 extra to maximum cold, or maybe Barbarism giving +1 to fire, and then you have other things such as Solo Steel that gives +1 to all maximum elemental resistances. This would make it so this 75 would go to 76. And even though a lot of people might not think that 1% is actually a lot, that 1% is actually a good form of mitigation, aka lower damage taken from these elemental forms of damage. So actually getting 76 or 77 that you can get is actually really good. But right now we're focusing on just getting 75. So if you look to the right of that, you can see that in the parentheses it says a number. That is the amount of resistances that my character actually has. There is never a problem to have above 75. Having things like 83, 86, and 95 is not an issue. And in some cases, if you play, for example, hardcore, you want that number to be extremely high. Because later on when you're going to start mapping, some maps have different forms of modifiers that lower your resistances overall. Like, you can enter a map with a modifier called Elemental Weakness that lowers your elemental resistances. So if I have 75, 75, 75, enter Elemental Weakness map, I might have 60, 60, 60 instead, which is going to make it really bad for me because I will take a ton of elemental damage and I can easily be killed. Now, another question that you might have is, my chaos resistance currently is minus 60%. This is pretty normal when you play softcore, because a lot of people generally don't really care about getting chaos resistances. Obviously, there is chaos damage in the game, but it's not very normal. And actually getting chaos res on gear can be very, very difficult. There are different ways that you can, like, completely neglect all forms of chaos damage with things such as chaos inoculation, which is played by a lot of different characters, but you play this with a very special build where you utilize energy shield instead of life, because when you use chaos inoculation, your life becomes one and you become immune to chaos damage, and therefore you instead focus on energy shield, for example. So having minus 60 isn't really a problem, but getting it as high as you can is obviously good, but it can be very difficult as well. For example, Cirrus in the endgame of Path of Exile, the endgame boss, he does a little bit of chaos damage, but I've killed him many times with having minus 60 as well. It just takes a while to like kind of understand the playstyle of not having chaos rest when you play Path of Exile, because like I said, there are forms of chaos damage here and there, but it doesn't really occur too often. So if you have minus 60, don't be alarmed, it's fine. If you want to get your chaos rest up though, that is absolutely fine to do as well, but you don't have to panic and be like, I'm gonna die every single time I enter a map. That's not really gonna happen. So what you need to do is that you need to go over the build or the guide that you're following, and you need to look at like, what kind of gear can I buy now once I finish Act 10 Kitaba, or what kind of gear have I looted myself that actually contains these different things that I need. For example, me and my character right now, I have focused a lot on my helmet, my boots, my amulet, my two rings, and my belt to actually gain some form of elemental resistances. And keep in mind that you do need quite a lot in order to actually hit 75 or higher. So currently I have bought a helmet that has, fire, lightning, cold, and lightning. I also have an amulet that has lightning. I also have a ring that has fire and cold, and then more fire and cold. I have another ring that has fire and cold. I have a studded belt that gives me 25% all resistances if I have at least 200 strength, which I do have. And I have a pair of boots that gives me fire, cold, and lightning. And all these things together accumulate enough defenses for me to actually hit 75 or higher, which is enough for me to start mapping. Another thing that you also need to keep in mind is that there are different forms of defenses in Path of Exile, and you want to make sure that you have some form of defenses, because a high life pool is extremely good, but if you have nothing to mitigate damage or actually not take damage in the first place, you can still get smashed pretty hard. I will always suggest a high life pool paired with some form of defenses, but some characters in the game, just as my character right now, I have a very low health pool, so I try to focus a lot on other forms of defenses. So in Path of Exile, you have armor, you have energy shield, you have life, you have mana, you have evasion, and different forms of evade. So currently on my character that I'm playing right now, I'm utilizing a health pool, and I'm utilizing evasion and evade. So evasion is basically how agile your character is. Like, let's say you're in a boxing match, and like you're dodging all the guy's like punches to you, you know, like you're evading his attacks basically. So that's what my character is focusing on. I have 4000 evasion rating, which means that I have a 34% chance to actually like dodge an incoming attack from my mob. A mob tries to hit me, I have a 34% chance for the mob to actually miss me and don't even hit me at all. And then I have a chance to dodge as well attacks, and a chance to dodge spells as well. And what I'm saying is that I'm basically going for a lot of evasion on my character, and I'm also playing with acrobatics and face acrobatics, which gives me the dodge to attacks. And then I just try to get as much evasion on my character as possible in the skill tree or on my character overall. I have an evasion based helmet. This helmet, as you can see on the top, gives me 464 evasion. My boots give me 200. And then I don't really have too much else on top of that. I have armor and evasion on my, you know, gloves and stuff like that. But the main forms of defenses that you usually get is on your belt, your gloves, boots, helmet, and armor. And then you try to pair, you know, good life and resistances on, for example, maybe jewelry and boots and stuff like that. It totally depends on what build you're playing and how you're making your character. But those are where I have my main form of defenses. I also have evasion in my ascendancy from Gathering Winds. As soon as I use an attack, I will gain Tailwind, and I will gain evasion rating when I have Tailwind as well. So I will basically show you my evasion rating go up when I am attacking. As you can see here, my evasion rating is, where did it go now? There we go, 4,244. And when I attack, it goes up to 7,300. And you can see my estimated chance to evade attacks went up a lot, actually. It went up quite decent amount. So yeah, you need to focus on what kind of defenses that your character has as well. So like I said, 3000 life pool is not that good. I would rather have maybe 4.5 or 5000 health pool on this character, but I will increase that as I level up, and I will increase it as I continue to make my gear better. and my evasion will also go up, so I will build a good amount of defense on this character sooner or later. Many other characters focus on like mana because they might place things such as mind over matter, or they might use armor, and just armor mitigates any damage that you take. Like if you have a lot of armor, you take a punch doesn't even do that damage to you because you have so much armor instead. And some characters focus on energy shield, which is another form of life pool basically, where it's like a magic shield that's called energy shield that you take damage instead of your life pool first, and then you take damage in the life pool after your energy shield is drained. But yeah, so that's basically what you want to focus on if you just finished Act 10 Kitava, is that you want to focus on getting your resistances up, looking at what kind of defenses you have and if you have enough, and then you want to make sure that your damage is enough. So go do the quest with Kirik after you finish Act 10 Kitava and try out a tier 1 map. If you feel like you're not killing mobs fast enough and if you're dying too much, you have to revisit your character and look at what gear can upgrade. Is it my weapons? Is it my skill tree? Is it my build overall? Is my defense is not good enough? I'm dying all the time. I have 2000 life and I have no defenses whatsoever, and I don't even have my elemental resistance up. Then you're just going to die a ton, which is super boring in Path of Exile to just die over and over again. And when you start mapping, you want to die as little as possible, because now the real grind begins and you just want to push all the time. So dying 3 times per map is not fun at all. So those are the main things that you should focus on. And yep, this is something that's very important for everyone in Path of Exile, even more so if you play hardcore as well, where you never want to die, because if you die in hardcore, your character is basically gone to standard, which is the land of the dead, basically. So, you know, these are very important things to think of when you finish Act 10 Kitava, and I hope that you enjoyed the video as well. Thank you very much for watching. Remember to subscribe here on YouTube, or go check me out on Twitch as well, where I stream almost daily over at twitch.tv/burgerbrush. I wish you all a great day, and thank you very much for watching.